It gave me cooling perks. I did get testicular atrophy. It's gonna shrink your balls. Your testes shrink and shrivel up, you know? I mean, it's smaller.
And it's maintained that shrinkage?
Yeah, it does not cut back.
Wow. Like old times. What is going on, aliens? I'm Mike Rosa, founder and CEO of Anabolic Aliens, where we specialize in personalized fitness. We've been helping millions online for over a decade accomplish their fitness goals, and our fitness app XPRIZE has over 500,000 users today. And today, we got a very special video with a very special guest, Leo Von Fitness.
How's it going today, aliens? We're going to be discussing steroids, my journey with steroids, and are steroids worth it for you?
You aliens know me. I've never taken any PEDs before and I don't plan on it, but I get a lot of questions about them, especially considering our company name is Anabolic Aliens. Anabolic means to grow to build. It does not mean steroids, but we're going to answer some really tough questions today and go deep and transparent into the concept of steroids. And that's why we got Leo Von Fitness to be transparent with all of you aliens. So I asked you aliens to ask us a bunch of questions on what you want me to ask him. Let's get into this video.
Let's get into the video. No more fluff questions. We're getting right into the heart of the matter.
All right, these questions are coming right from the aliens. First question, what made you feel the need to take steroids in the first place?
What made me feel the need to take steroids in the first place was this sensation that this idea that I was not getting the gains that I wanted from the gym. I went to my doctor, and being a firefighter paramedic, I wasn't getting enough sleep at night, where I wake 24 hours often, and my testosterone was really low at like 300 nanograms per deciliter, which is the low range on average from 300 to 900. And the reality of the situation was, went to the doctor, got blood work, and although it was 300, I was also drinking constantly. I wasn't eating a good diet, wasn't getting good sleep. I wasn't working out at all. So anyone's testosterone, even at the young age of 25 at the time, my testosterone should have been low. So I started taking steroids nonetheless. I was getting the gains that I wanted and kind of fell addicted to there from that point there.
So it really became a matter of you wanted to get results and you weren't even seeing results, which made you go jump right into the steroid use.
Yes. And I felt justified just having low testosterone. And my doctor, you know, read the notes, you know, having low testosterone, he thought, okay, well, we can boost this, but maybe just by the under the recommendation, changing my diet and getting into a healthy habit of working out, eating healthy, I would have been boosting my testosterone naturally.
Interesting. So you kind of just skip that in general and right to the enhanced.
Of course, you know, I let myself get a little bit influenced by these influencers and seeing them have the gains so quickly and seeing them like only a year on steroids, saying they're going to get shredded. I really was kind of addicted to thinking I was going to be shredded instantly. And you get the muscle gains for sure, but there's no reason to cut the corners. You know, getting it naturally is something I really wish I would have done.
Next question. Has this journey or decision pushed you to max strength and endurance?
Steroids are steroids, man. I absolutely did get the gains that I wanted and I got the endurance that I wanted. You do immediately get this enhancement of being able to lift more weight and for more reps, and all the food and stuff that you eat and the sleep that you get is utilized like 100%. And the answer to the question is absolutely. Absolutely.
Really? You feel like you hit a max point though?
No, there is no threshold. And that's why a lot of bodybuilders will suggest that taking PEDs actually is the hard route and natural is the easy route, because you will plateau naturally. There is the sky's the limit with steroids, and it doesn't mean you have to just keep taking. They just keep working, you know.
Really? There's no plateau?
No, there's not going to be a plateau. Not really. If you're doing the right workouts and you're eating enough food, you will always grow.
Does the food though matter? You said before that anything you were eating was kind of being optimized. Could you be going to McDonald's and be getting the same results? Like, how does that work in terms of the food consumption?
Well, when it comes to certain things, believe it or not, insulin is one of the most anabolic things that you can take. Not a lot of people know that aren't in the bodybuilder industry. But when these bodybuilders, you see them crushing 12 donuts after a workout or eating a lot of McDonald's, they're utilizing all the carbohydrates and calories because they're taking insulin to absorb all that nutrition. So it goes from calories into muscle gains, really, if I could put it in layman's terms. So no, you should not eat McDonald's. No, you should not eat unhealthy food. It should be chicken, rice, broccoli the whole way. But you will get size no matter what you eat, as long as you're eating enough protein and calories.
Now, I'm taking it from a natural perspective, but the enhanced perspective, McDonald's versus clean eating, like you just said, you're going to be able to get gains from both. Mm-hmm. Fat loss perspective, is the healthier food going to optimize fat loss more? Because naturally, obviously, but enhanced wise, does it make much of a difference?
So it still makes much of a difference. Calories in, calories out still stands hold to be true. Especially with steroids, but steroids will enhance your metabolism. So you can eat a lot more and get away with it because your body needs it in order to sustain the muscle mass that you have. So it's still going to be calories in, calories out. But again, like with even natural, eating McDonald's and losing weight is going to look a lot different from eating rice and chicken and losing weight.
Yeah. So really, you say calories in, calories out. That's more regarding the weight loss, weight gain proponent.
Correct.
For the macros, though, carbs, proteins, fats, that is going to be dependent on clean versus unclean eating. And
yes. Yeah, I would say as long as you're keeping your protein to a certain point, like a gram per body weight, but the higher protein intake, the more likely you're going to be burning more fat instead. So higher protein when you're on a cut, and then standard protein when you're bulking up.
Yeah.
So like a gram per body pound when you're bulking, and then I would even go to 1.5 grams for body weight, per pound of body weight for cutting.
Yeah, I go a gram per pound for protein myself.
Yeah, yeah, same.
Can an 18-year-old take MK677 for height growth plus bulking?
So height growth, MK677 is a peptide that is enhancing. It is going to help your pituitary gland produce more human growth hormone. And, you know, young children in their adolescence going through puberty, taking human growth hormone, about 2 IUs for years, meaning like up to 2 years, can see a huge burst in a growth spurt. But we're out of that phase in our life when you're 18, and you're not going to be expecting to be any taller. I don't care how much human growth hormone you're taking. Maybe your hands get bigger, maybe your feet get bigger, but nothing else gets bigger, trust me.
But you're saying during your growth spurt, it will actually aid in your height development?
Yeah, a lot of kids who are stunted in the growth for whatever the cause may be, a lot of doctors will prescribe them human growth hormone, about 2 IUs, 1 to 2 IUs, for like 2 years at a time in order to get a regular human amount of growth for their puberty.
Yeah, and you said HGH. Can you relate HGH again to MK677?
Yeah, MK677 is a peptide that stimulates your human growth hormone production.
Gotcha.
So what gains you'll get is you can get some muscle gains from, and I'm going to keep calling it human growth hormone, but this is kind of a, what do they call it? Not a peptide. This is a...
SARM?
SARM, exactly. Exactly. That's what I'm looking for, this SARM. So you can get muscle gains from it. But a lot of people are going to go towards it to get a leaner body look and gain muscle mass. Human growth hormone is the same way. You're looking to get more fat loss from human growth hormone instead of an anabolic boost.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Coupled with steroids, though, you can see a huge growth in muscle gains if you're taking both.
SARMs with the steroids?
Yes, because that human growth hormone factor will allow you to just, you're signaling your whole body to keep growing. And if you have anabolics on top of that, it can be exponential.
How can someone know when they might need some help, like get TRT?
So always talk to a doctor. And these HRT clinics, hormone replacement therapy clinics, they're going to always try to sell you on their product because they're trying to make a profit as well. And it's not that no one's going to benefit. Almost everybody will benefit from it, to be honest. But you really want to stay as natural as long as possible. That sort of golden rule stands still with bodybuilders all the time. TRT, it's needed when you cannot sustain a low level of testosterone, when you're always drowsy, always tired, never having enough energy, and your blood work shows you have low testosterone. But if you haven't tried eating healthy, working out daily, and getting enough sleep for months on end before trying again to see your blood work, if it's still low after all those factors, maybe then you can start considering TRT. But even in your 20s, if you're getting only 300 nanograms per deciliter on the lower end of the scale of testosterone, that still looks different for everybody. I could be gaining huge muscles and feeling super energetic and have a high sex drive at 300 nanograms per deciliter, while some guy at 700 doesn't feel any of those symptoms. They feel drowsy and a low sex drive and low libido. So that number just varies for person to person. It's very treat the patient, not the monitor, is what I like to say. Is how does the patient look? What are the symptoms versus what the numbers are in the blood work? Because sometimes you can be, you know, as alpha male as possible at 300 nanograms per deciliter, you know?
Yeah, and you were telling me something earlier, though, that it doesn't make much of a difference for certain people.
Yes, yeah, everybody on TRT, they are not getting the muscle gains that you're thinking. This is not anabolic. This is not for the purpose of muscle gains. This is just for better sleep, higher energy performance, higher libido. This is when you're struggling to have those male dominant attributes.
Now, it's interesting because I feel like TRT has been a incredibly popularized trend, especially for younger people, and it's been accredited to gaining more gains. from TRT? Do you think it's because people just weren't doing things correctly in the beginning and then they get on to the TRT and then mentally it's kind of like that placebo effect where they're like, well, now they're starting to eat healthier, they're starting to lift more often, they're starting to get better sleep because they have that TRT and the TRT itself isn't correlating to the gains?
100%. You're spot on. That's exactly what happened with me in my experience. I started hopping on the TRT and I wanted to make the most of it. So now I'm making sure never to drink. Now I'm making sure I sleep as much as I can. I'm working out as much as I can. I'm eating super healthy. So that placebo effect of thinking that it's working probably was just because of my better choice of habits after taking it.
Interesting.
Yeah. But I will want to forewarn anybody who, especially when they're young, trying to take TRT, that is simply your mind wanting you. It's your gateway to steroids. It's you thinking like, oh, I'm just doing TRT. Well, now you're going to start doubling the dose before you know it.
Ask him about the best way to optimize genetic potential. Now, I'm assuming we're going to relate that with steroid use.
Yeah, so optimizing genetic potential, if we can start with natural, it's just going to be sleep, eat healthy, work out. That's it. If you can do those three things, natty or not, these are going to be what enhances your gains. People on steroids really tend to focus on these three things because these foundations are what it takes to make serious gains. If you're working out really hard, if you're eating really healthy, and you're sleeping as much as you possibly can, you will see results. So that is the best way to optimize your genetic potential. But I also like when people, like someone like yourself, you genetically have huge biceps, bigger biceps than me. And it's just because genetically you have better muscle bellies than I do on your biceps. So to enhance that look, focus on your biceps and now you'll have even bigger biceps. So that's where I would say you're enhancing your genetic potential. I have bigger glutes and back. So when I work on my glutes and back, I know they're going to accentuate really well with my physique. Or the opposite, maybe I'm going to stop working on those to even out my look. Maybe you have really big biceps and your chest doesn't look as big as your biceps. So now you need to start working on your chest to catch up to your biceps. I think that would help you reach your genetic potential.
Two things. You say you have a small chest? But realistically, I want to actually relate this about like the steroid use specifically.
Sure.
Did you, when you were taking steroids, were you choosing the type of steroid to complement specific parts of genetic weaknesses?
So steroids, you always hear about cutting cycles and bulking cycles. And what that really means is bulking cycles really don't focus on making you look dry. And they're just focused on enhancing gains. So people will take DECA and Dianabol, which make you fill up with water. A lot of people have problems with that because it raises your blood pressure as well. But when you don't care about your aesthetic, you're just trying to get gains, you're going to go for those type of steroids. When you're trying to stay lean and cut, you're going to take like Trenbolone, ACE, testosterone, propionate. These are fast-acting drugs that keep you looking dry and lean throughout your cycle. But when it comes to cutting and bulking, cutting is really just for a show. If you're not competing, you shouldn't be cutting, in my opinion. Cutting is just for the summer body, maybe photos, magazine, maybe you own a fitness company and you want to look the part. But cutting phases, I think, are overrated. And I'm only cutting for a competition.
I got you. But I want to narrow in one more, a little bit on the type of steroid that you're choosing. Mm-hmm. Like, is there specific steroids for helping more with the bicep development, helping more with the leg development, or is it more generalized?
They're all broad spectrum. They're all just going to perform throughout your body, growth. It doesn't matter if you're trying to grow biceps, legs, it's all going to grow as long as you're working them out. Cool. Accentuates your performance. Basically, steroids kind of give you 5 times the enhancement. So what would take me a year, I can get 5 years worth by taking anabolics.
Is roids worth going on as a young teenager for goals like Mr. Olympia?
So this is going to be, my short answer is absolutely not. But I would also say that, you know, wait until you're like 25 if you really, really have the goals of going to Mr. Olympia. But at the same time, you see these young Olympians under 30 years old and they're at Mr. Olympia. And to get there, you have to do whatever it takes. So I'm not going to tell anyone not to follow their dreams. But I cannot advocate that for you. I'm not going to advocate for anyone under, I don't want anyone using steroids, to be honest, but I cannot advocate for a young person to use steroids. I don't think you should go that route without seeking your maximum potential naturally, because that'll give you a good insight if you can make it to Olympia. If you're already getting this huge physique by the age of 20, well, maybe you have some potential there. But if you're not seeing the potential and you're just really scrawny and you're like, I want to be Olympian, so now I can justify steroids, I don't agree.
Yeah, I don't want to say an unintelligent response, but I don't think it's possible to win Mr. Olympia without steroids at this point in history.
100% correct. I don't think anyone would disagree with that statement. I mean, the competition these days, they keep making it about getting bigger, 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 drier, 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 leaner, leaner, leaner. And there's just, if you're not taking them, someone else is.
Yeah, and it's, I think what you said earlier, what is really sad, honestly, about the influencer world is that a lot of people go through where you went through. If they skip that natural phase, yes, and have no idea their actual potential, and a lot of them get detrimental results because they just end up hurting their bodies, their performance, without actually doing their own natural experiment.
Yes. You know? Yeah. A lot of people, they suffer with steroid side effects like acne, hair loss. And if you're already suffering with these things without steroids, it's going to accentuate these factors. Same with like roid rage. If you're someone who gets pissed off easily, this is going to be enhanced. So I never really had problems with acne or hair loss really, but now that as I get older, my hair loss is getting a little bit more. So that was getting accentuated when I was on steroids, but I never really had back knee problems or acne problems. But if you had those already naturally, it's going to be accentuated. And some people don't realize how bad the situation is until they get on steroids. And it takes a while before they get out of your body.
Very simple. Is it worth it?
Short answer, no. I am happy with the gains that I've got from steroids and to complement steroids. Not to complement steroids. I've kept a lot of it. But now that I've done the show, I've done shows with it, and I've done shows without it, I see that it's just not worth it. Unless you're trying to go for Olympia, unless you really are this bodybuilder guy who's going for gains, trying to win trophies, there's no other reason to take this. It is not healthy. I did have blood work problems. I did have health problems. I did have behavioral health problems as well. And they don't happen right away sometimes. I was taking gear for over 3 years. And it was only on the third year that I started really noticing problems. And it's why I'm clean off of them now.
Can you go a little bit detail on the blood problems first?
Yeah, a lot of it was mainly just like cholesterol going up. And this isn't something that I should take, you know, I should take seriously. And I did by stopping. But being a young male, I just felt like having triglycerides that are through the roof and LDL at the bottom, or LDL at the roof and HDL at the bottom of the floor. I thought, you know, I'm 28, I can still handle this. But the reality is that's when plaque builds up. That's when you get clogged arteries. That's when your blood pressure starts elevating. You don't need to hurt your body this young. Just because you can take it this young doesn't mean it's going to help you out in the future. You know, you want to have as little cardiac issues as possible as you get older.
That's a great perspective too, because I feel like people do things when they're young knowing they can get more away with it.
Yeah.
And it hits them hard later on in life.
Yeah. And I never thought it happened to me. I thought I'd stop at 30. That was my goal. It's like, roid it out till 30, only 5 years of steroids, I'll be fine. Well, 3 years later, I'm really, really glad that I stopped.
Can you go a little bit more into detail on the behavioral part now?
Yeah, the behavioral health. So we all know body dysmorphia. And we all know that once you start looking smaller, you know, you might start getting a little bit of that body dysmorphia and feeling a little depressed about your physique in the mirror. But I never was struggling with the physique in the mirror. I accepted that I was going to lose probably 10 pounds every time I was off cycle. But it also affects mental health with like depression. And I felt immense amounts of depression that I understood were coming from the steroids, but it didn't take away the effects of the depression. Being self-aware was not enough. And even to this day, I still go to weekly therapy for it. And it's something that it's one of the biggest reasons why I actually regret steroids. It's not really how it's affected my body or my blood work as much as the mental side of it. You know, it really affects you, and you go from this God complex to inferiority complex. And those peaks and valleys are never worth it. And again, I thought I was young, able to handle it, but I even get a little bit shaky now talking about it. But it's worth it to stay off. I'm in a better mental state now and still recovering from it. And I stopped in August of 2023. So it still kind of shows you this takes time, and you don't have to go through what I went through.
Yeah, one of the things I always say to my clients is your mentality gives you the strength and perseverance to see physical change. If you're not mentally strong, it's going to hit you physically. It's going to hit every aspect of your life way beyond just fitness, in my opinion.
I love that. That's really powerful.
Do you feel anyone can safely benefit from temporarily using steroids to boost their results?
I would always say that steroids are never temporary. It's kind of like that saying there's no such thing as one cycle, and there is not. If you start with TRT, you're going to end up doing steroids, especially if you're doing it at a young age. It is not justified to ever do TRT. It is so rare that someone under 30 needs any sort of enhancement without trying to eat healthier, sleep better, work out more. But these steroid cycles that people think, oh, I'll just do one cycle, or I'll just do 1 year. That's what I did. And I fell victim to it like we all do when we start. Because you see the gains, you see the growth, you get compliments, you're the biggest guy in the room, you go in the gym, and you know, people look at you, they call you big guy. It's probably your first time being called big guy. And you get addicted to that feeling. And when it stops, you stop.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you get really demotivated. And so I would never say there's a healthy way to just do it a little bit. I would consider what I was doing very healthy, especially when I was competing. Even right now, I'm eating the same 6 meals every day. I'm working out every single day. I do cardio every single day. And my blood work was still showing negative results. And that was back in August. My blood work was still showing negative results. So even at the young age of 28, as low of a dosage of gear as I was taking and working out super healthy and getting a lot of sleep, I was still having negative results. So you can't always out-train and out-eat anabolic use, androgynous hormones.
You kind of touched on this a little bit, but we'll re-answer this one. What is his plan as far as longevity of taking steroids? Does he plan to stop, etc.?
So I would not be completely honest if I didn't say what I was taking now. And although I said I'm not going to be taking anabolic steroids, I am still taking TRT, and I am actually taking human growth hormone. I'm doing a low dose of 2 IUs a day, and I plan on taking growth hormone for the rest of my life. And TRT, I'm unfortunately having to take for the rest of my life because of the testicular atrophy I've experienced through my anabolic abuse. And so now I don't produce natural testosterone. I tried for months on end, and I even took post-psychotherapy drugs such as HCG and Clomid, and it wasn't successful. And so that just kind of goes to show you again, at the right young age of 28, even with Clomid, HCG, these drugs that help produce natural testosterone, I still was not getting the full benefit every time I got off of them. I still was at 100 nanograms per deciliter in my blood work. So taking TRT, I'm taking human growth hormone. Human growth hormone, if I could compliment it, has a lot of rejuvenating factors in it and anti-aging factors in it, like helping with hair growth, helps with your skin, nails, bone density. There are a lot of positives to taking human growth hormone. Unfortunately, it's very expensive to get from a clinic, though. A lot of people pay upwards of like $750 a month for it. And so if you can afford it, I actually recommend it. But talk to your doctor first. Don't listen to me. I'm just some guy. But yeah, that's all I'm taking gear-wise and all I plan on taking for the rest of my life.
Now, I don't want to say you're being contradictory, but I do want to ask and go a little bit more into detail on I can tell from your responses you're not recommending steroids. Mm-hmm. So why are you saying you're going to take this for the rest of your life?
So the reason why I'm taking, TRT, I sort of have to take, unfortunately, from my abuse, but human growth hormone, I'm going to take for the rest of my life just because it has a lot of positive side effects. It does help keep you leaner, does help burn body fat. It does help with muscle atrophy. So not very losing gains. And again, it helps with all sorts of things, but there are negative side effects to it too. So if you ever had like signs of cancer, or if you ever had cancer in the past, you cannot take human growth hormone because there is studies showing correlation, maybe not causation, but correlation that it can cause cancer to come back or cancer that you haven't detected yet to grow. Mm-hmm. So hopefully we'll cross our fingers there. No. But you know, the risk is everything.
Would you be saying that if you've never taken any type of steroid before, like, are you recommending HGH?
If you are serious about taking steroids and you haven't yet, and you know you're going to take it against my recommendations or a doctor's recommendations, I would absolutely say that the safer drugs you can take are testosterone and human growth hormone. And I wish from the very get-go that that was all I took, knowing the health benefits that they have.
Why does he feel the need to take steroids? Is there a specific goal he has?
So I do plan on being Mr. Olympia one day for classic physique class A, 175 pounds. I do love bodybuilding. I think it's going to be a part of my fitness journey for the rest of my life. I love competing. I love stepping on stage. I love being in the center of attention, Leo. Bodybuilding's my goal.
And that's what got you really to get into steroid use.
It is. At first, it was sort of justification to allow myself to get into steroids. It's, oh, well, I'm going to be a bodybuilder, so it's okay to do. But now I'm trying to take as little as possible, such as my TRT prescription and human growth hormone prescription.
This is absolutely a video that I'd watch only if you aren't giving fluff questions. So let's go through a couple of his. Have you always used PEDs? If not, what circumstances pushed you to leave a natural lifestyle? If so, what conditions made you disregard a clean workout journey?
So I let myself get influenced by these YouTubers and these TikTokers, Instagram models. I see them having the results, some of them being open about their usage, made it just feel okay to do. And telling myself I'm going to do it as healthy as possible, I'm a very zero or 110% kind of guy. And so I thought, as long as I get 110%, I can do this safely and healthily. With a good health. And 3 years down the road, found out that you can't always out-eat and out-train anabolic use. You can still have negative side effects from it. I did have to stop, but I just wanted that dream body. I wanted to be that fitness model. I wanted to be on stage looking shredded and dicey like all these guys do it. But now that I've done it naturally and enhanced, I know what it takes to do it naturally, and it is possible. And I'm going to do it with as little enhancement as I'm taking now.
When you started, were you aware of the risks involved? Are the risks taken seriously in the community? If so, explain how harm reduction awareness is spread. If not, explain the general attitude towards PEDs and their positive and negative effects.
Beautiful question. So I'll start with this. When you start taking anabolics and you start boosting your testosterone really high, that will innately make you take more risks. As you become more of this like alpha male, you know, men go out and back in the day killed lions and tigers and bears. And, you know, when you have that high level of testosterone, you're willing to take those risks. And that's why a lot of guys are willing to just say, screw the side effects. I'm taking this anyway. Or I know what the side effects are. If I see them, I'll stop. But the reality is we don't stop. We see the side effects and maybe cut back, but the gains are too juicy and too good, pun intended. And you don't want to stop. You see the gains, you see the striations, you see the huge growth. And who cares if you have a little bit of backing? Who cares if you have some anger issues? Who cares if you're having like heart palpitations? You'll see guys just stop caring. And I equate that to these high levels of testosterone. You know, it's endogenous hormones that you're putting inside your body, and it's inhuman. And you start thinking inhumanly. You start thinking from like this God complex of it's worth it. Even though it's not, you kind of become delusional. And I can relate to that 100%.
In states where it's illegal without a prescription, how do users find their product? Is it readily available online? Or are they crooked doctors working in the black market? What's the process from purchase to delivery?
So oftentimes there are now, it's becoming a fad actually, is seeing all these HRT clinics online. Some people are, you will see sponsorships from like transcend.com is a good one. They'll do your blood work, you send in blood work, and they send a prescription for your blood work to you, show it to your doctor or like a lab corp or whatever, get your blood results. That's kind of a part of your consultation, is doing your blood work with them. They send in the blood work, and then they are able to prescribe you things from there. Sometimes you can even get things like Anavar, testosterone, even DECA, low dosages of DECA, and they mail it to you. But it's possible to do it, but, you know, I don't know the legal terms for your states or whoever's asking, but that is something that you can do, is look online, but be wary. Things online, there's a lot of shady stuff out there, of course. And, you know, you don't want black market anything. You know, you're taking a huge risk as is by taking these supplements. No need to add on the risk.
Do you think bodybuilding influencers play an active, passive role in creating new PED users? What about pro bodybuilders? What responsibility do bodybuilding influencers have when forming their audiences on PEDs and their personal usage?
I think when we do something like this, a Q&A with an influencer or a bodybuilder, it is up to them to answer these questions as honest as possible if they're trying to keep people safe. Because when you talk about the negatives, you at least help people understand that the negatives are real and you can face them. So I think it is up to these bodybuilders to understand that, but it's not their choice whether you do steroids or not. It is up to these people who are being influenced, such as myself, I was influenced and it's not their fault that I did it. I am an adult and I made my choices. So I took the risks there. You know, I can't tell them to stop because, you know, I'm on my way to try and be an influencer myself. But I think if I keep myself as open and honest as possible about these types of issues and concerns, that I can keep the world a little bit safer and stop these young kids from just blasting things in their cheeks so that they can look as anabolic as possible.
100%. Transparency and accountability.
Yeah.
Since we're not going to have you show how PEDs are administered, can you explain the typical process when you use PEDs, though?
Typically, it depends on what you're taking. When you're taking a fast-acting supplement, you're going to be using it probably every other day, and usually these are injectables. Pills are usually taken like before workout and maybe before bed, 12 hours apart or something like that. But it's all dependent on what you're taking. Some things are daily, such as like human growth hormone, and some things are slow acting. So you do it, maybe you pin, which is the term for injecting, twice a week, like Monday and Thursday is a popular day, or Monday, Wednesday, Friday. But the more you pin, the more evened out the hormones are going to be throughout your body. So you're having less peaks and valleys. So if you're doing just one big dose on Friday, you're going to have that one big dose and then decline like this by Monday or next Friday. So it's better to do like Monday, Wednesday, Friday, depending on the compound that you're taking.
Has he noticed that he can recover quicker between sessions?
I would say I definitely notice I can recover between sessions well. And that soreness factor sort of goes away. Even when you're natural, you stop getting sore after a certain point. But I know from leg day to leg day, I would still be sore sometimes when I was natural by that next leg day in the week. But now, not only is that leg day, I'm performing just as well on each leg day. I feel like the recovery time really is enhanced. And when you sleep, you get better sleep. The sleep like matters so much more, and you heal so much faster. They definitely help with recovery, and I think that's what makes anabolic use so detrimental to gains.
Yep. So there is a significant difference between recovery naturally and recovery enhanced.
Absolutely. And the recovery enhanced is enhanced.
How easy was the access to these enhancements? Does the financial aspect play a key role?
So you definitely get what you pay for, and I definitely, you know, stay wary of these people that you see in the gym. Some guys will even see you have some gains, tell you you have potential, or maybe even want to sponsor you and give you some free gear. The black market's sort of like the only way to go about it. Obviously, you're not getting these, at least in America, and you're not getting this from a doctor or anything. But you just got to understand you're taking risks when you're taking this stuff. And if you're going to do it against advice, at least do very low dosages and work your way up. Do one compound at a time. Don't start taking the whole shelf of medications, you know, at once. You know, see what one thing affects at a time, you know, for each cycle.
Yeah, I know for me, I get offered steroids all the time. Yeah. It's pretty crazy. Like I would say 2-3 times a week, someone different is offering me steroids.
Yeah, yeah. And it'll be in your own gym. You know, they see somebody who has some serious gains. They're like, he must use or must want to use, mm-hmm. You know?
It's always an assumption.
Yeah, yeah. They're always going to assume that you're not natty.
Here's an interesting one. Does it make his accomplishments feel hollow and bring him guilt when complimented as if he cheated on a test and got an A+, while others who studied harder only got a B?
I will absolutely say not. I do actually even agree with some bodybuilders that say that being enhanced makes it more difficult because, again, the sky's the limit. You know, you can always get bigger, whereas like when you're natural, there is a limit. But I'll tell you what, my first competition, I got second place in both my categories. And the two guys that beat me, both natural.
Really?
Yep. And they were 10 pounds lighter than I was. And so it really taught me that I can get shredded like they are, and I can still win as a natural. Well, natural-esque nowadays. But
so you don't feel like you cheated?
I don't feel like I cheated. And I would even go as far as to say I'm more proud of my gains. But I will say that by the end of my last cycle, when I was as big as I was, 184 pounds, 4% body fat, I felt like, okay, I get it. You know, this was fun, but I'm almost bored of being so big. I sort of feel like it's more of a challenge now to do it naturally in regards of, it's kind of contradicting what I was saying, but I know that you can just keep getting bigger with steroids. And I felt like I was bored of being big. So now seeing how big I can get naturally is actually, more interesting. because now that's my new challenge, because I never tried natural first. I did PEDs right from the jump, and now I get to see how hard is it going to be as natural as I'm trying to be.
Interesting. So my understanding from what you said, it's really the addiction of just getting better. And if you're enhanced, you can keep on getting better. Yep. And now, since you got to a certain size, you're like, I'm kind of bored of being this big. Now you're trying to, on the other end of the spectrum, do it naturally and see how big you can get naturally. Yes. But you're addicted to the factor of progression.
Yes, yes. Yeah, and discipline. It is, you certainly are more disciplined to do this naturally. I don't want to diminish that at all. There is a lot more discipline because there's the simple discipline of like, don't do it. Don't put that needle in your butt. You know, you're like, you're wanting to get enhanced, and fighting that battle even is discipline on its own. So trying to bodybuild and compete with this guy that's next to you, who's got striations and cap shoulders, peaked traps, you know, it's going to be difficult, but I encourage it.
You can always ask him if he flambéed his organs, shrunk his sac, gave him back knee in rage.
So I got one out of the four. It gave me a coin purse. I did get testicular atrophy. And so you do shrink your balls. It's going to shrink your balls. I didn't notice it until I started taking more compounds, but just testosterone or TRT is not going to give you that effect. But when you no longer need to make testosterone, your testes shrink and shrivel up, you know?
How significant are we talking?
Now, I've always had what I would call a coin purse, but I noticed that it's even smaller now. I mean, it's smaller now.
And it's maintained that shrinkage?
Yeah, yeah. It does not come back.
That's, wow.
Yeah, and that's why people would take post-psychotherapy drugs like Clomid and ACG to help. They're fertility drugs. And so they help you become more fertile and have more sperm production, which does help engorge your testes. But the second I got off of those drugs, I immediately got back to my normal testes.
Gotcha. Should I take Dianabol as a beginner, and what are the side effects in the longer run? So D-ball specifically.
So Dianabol, the perks of Dianabol, I think what you need to first understand is what do these drugs do and how do they work? Like Anavar, for example, people need to understand that why Anavar works is because it makes your cardio easier. To put it in simple terms, it makes cardio easier. You can push through the pain. It's less painful. And you just feel this sense of energy, and you're able to run 5 miles when before you can only run 2. And that's why you're going to lose the weight on this cutting compound, because you're able to push yourself farther. So when we go to Dianabol, the reason why it works is because you can push heavier. You have to push heavier if you're going to get any sort of results. If you're pushing the same weight or just a little bit heavier, then you're only going to get minimal gains. It's not going to make you big, big, big without putting in the effort. I don't think it's a good start for anyone starting out with any PEDs. If you're going to go against medical advice and take PEDs anyway, just start with testosterone, start with like 400 milligrams and see what it does to you and see what that ester does to you. Are you doing a long range ester of like enanthate and cypionate, or are you doing a fast acting ester like propionate or sustanon?
Last question. On a scale 1 to 100, how did the pump feel when you worked out with steroids? What's that number now when you work out without steroids? How do you feel living with that number for the rest of your life?
100 on PEDs. I will say the pumps were crazy, but not only were the pumps insane while working out, doing something very small. I mean, I'm a firefighter and we're lifting heavy tools all the time, but just picking up an axe for like 5 minutes and putting it down, I'd have a serious arm pump in only one of my arms, you know? And so it made pumps a lot easier. So I kind of felt like my muscles were hard at all times. My veins were just pumping with blood at all times. It's orgasmic, I'll say that. I mean, it really is amazing, the pump that you get in the gym. And it's really encouraging, you know, a part of why steroids are so nice is that they produce a lot more dopamine with the higher testosterone level. So you get a lot more reward factor, and you even get more of an endorphin rush from your intense workouts. So it can be very addicting that way. But now without steroids and just taking human growth hormone and TRT, the pumps definitely aren't, I feel more natural. I can tell that I'm on planet Earth again. I'm not a god. And they feel more natural, but the pump is a pump is a pump, dude. I love a pump. I'll chase the pump forever. It still feels good. And my memory of how good it was on anabolics anyways, you know, months ago. So I can't even remember how good it was. You know, you start to forget it, and you stay focused on what you're dealing with. You know, you got to work with what you got.
the pump's addicting. I mean, I'm chasing pumps for the rest of my life naturally too. Like,
you got that right.
Yeah, you know, that's what we do. That's what we love.
That's right.
There you have it, aliens. Thank you for asking us questions and making this video awesome. Leo Von Fitness, thank you for joining us and being transparent. I think transparency is missing from the fitness industry, and it is so absolutely essential. I really think we need to enter this age of genuinity, bring it back to what is actually happening, what's real, because I don't think doing steroids is the problem. I don't think it's the actual thing holding people back or causing so much confusion. I think it's people lying about it.
Correct. I agree with you. Being genuine is what needs to, it saves people from the detriments of using steroids too. And so the more we can be transparent about the good side and the bad side, the better results people are going to get in the future. I appreciate your platform and having me. And it's been a great questions, you guys. I mean, you aliens are out of this world.
For real though, I really think like if you decide to do steroids, that's your choice. You can't blame anyone for your own actions. And I hope conversations like these can give you more of a transparent perspective on the realities of it. I have never taken PEDs. I didn't know the answers to the majority of these questions. And it was really insightful for me to hear all of Leovon's responses. So again, thank you for asking us a bunch of questions. Make sure to smash that thumbs up button for us and click that notification bell so you never miss a new video upload from me. And go click his link so you can go check out his stuff. That will be linked in the video description and first pinned comment. If you want more discussions like this, please leave a comment and let us know. We really appreciate all of you aliens. And I actually have a new free fitness plateau analyzer quiz that will also be linked in the first big comment and video description, where it'll help you identify what could be holding you back on your fitness journey, natural or not, actually. It will help identify your problems and will even provide you personalized solutions. So that is our free new fitness plateau analyzer quiz. Check that out in the first big comment and video description. And hey, thanks again, man. I really appreciate you. And I think this was an incredible conversation.
Great conversation. A great meeting, aliens. Thank you for all the awesome questions. You know, you guys, definitely no fluff here. Got straight to the point. I hope that I was able to answer it the best of my abilities.
If you have any more questions, leave them in those comments, and we will see you in that next video.
Peace.
Peace. Together, we got power. That's just rapping.